What's up, everyone? Ryan here, and I'm back with another Madden 24 Superstar Career Mode Series video, and it is time for a brand new season. We are starting the 2024 regular season today. Ryan Gamer is in his second season now in the NFL, and what an epic rookie season it was for Ryan. If you want the long version of the recap of last season, check out the previous video when we reviewed everything in the rookie season, but here for the short version. Ryan Gamer won a league MVP last season, Offensive Rookie Player of the Year, and led the Seattle Seahawks to not only win the division, but also to the NFC Championship, losing by 1 point to the Dallas Cowboys. So, it is time to get revenge this season and lead the Seattle Seahawks to the Super Bowl. The team has changed a lot, though. If you watched the last video, you know that. But this team, we lost a lot. We lost a lot defensively. We lost a lot on the offensive line. And Ryan Gamer lost his number one receiver of the season, which was Noah Fant, or our number one target. We still have DK Metcalf, and Ryan Gamer will have to throw Metcalf's way a lot. But you all know, if you watched last season, our main receiver was Noah Fant, the tight end. So Disley is stepping into Noah Fant's shoes. We'll see how well Disley can play. But we open week one in Detroit against the Lions. This is going to be a tough game. I need all of your all's one times. I need all the hype and positive encouraging comments. You all are all legends. Thank you so much for all the support here on this series and across all the Ryan Gamer Career Mode series on the channel. Ryan Gamer is the same athlete across all the sports. But here we go. It's time. Let's take a look at the Detroit Lions. They're 82 overall. We are sitting 83 overall. We have a +3 throw accuracy mid, +2 throw accuracy deep, and +2 speed. One thing I will say, I did set the season goal for passing for 4,000 yards. Ryan threw for over 4,000 yards last year and rushed for 1,800. So I think that's a good goal to set. It is time for week one of the 2024 NFL season, where Ryan Gamer is going to lead this team to the Super Bowl. It doesn't matter that we lost a lot of players. Yes, we have a new team. We can do this, everybody. We just gotta believe. You get some enjoyment, drop a like. It really helps the channel. Subscribe for more, and I have a full playlist linked for you all in the description. Looking for more episodes in this series. It is time. Ooh, that defense is tough. Detroit has a great team, led by Jack Campbell there. But we know what we're doing. We just gotta play our game, make smart decisions. We're gonna run the ball a lot this year. Just be ready for that.
It's week one of the National Football League. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Seahawks and the Lions, just ahead on EA Sports.
We got this. Hey, we got this, everybody. We just have to stay focused, and we just have to play our game. Come on.
First opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Today, it is the opener of the 2024 NFL season, as it'll be the Seattle Seahawks taking on the Detroit Lions. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, there's nothing quite like it, that feeling of beginning another NFL season. And these two squads, they're going to do just that in a moment.
And what makes it so exciting.
And you all just saw it, new coach as well. Coach Carroll did retire. Ryan Gamer drove Coach Carroll into retirement. So now we have Arthur Smith taking over as head coach. So that's a big change. But you all know Jerry is still the defensive coordinator. You better believe it. He earned it there at the last season. First drive of the season comes up right now. We don't get the ball. Detroit uses half of the quarter to get a field goal. Wow. Used a lot of time on that drive, didn't they?
Demands attention.
We're seeing it more and more in this league, how teams love to
wake up everybody
back there taking the snaps, guys who can throw it and move around and get yards with their legs if needed. He's one of the best examples that we see out there right now. He can throw for hundreds of yards one week and then run for 100 plus the next.
That's right. That's what Ryan does.
Dimension that really confounds defenses when he puts it all together.
Audible to the right, wide open. Kenneth Walker's going to have a big year.
He's got this past the 35 to about the 37.
He had a big year last year.
Let's do PA bootleg. Based on a terrific offseason.
Get it moving.
And runs like that on opening weekend Show that he's right.
Hey, let's see if we can get Disley some confidence early. I'm actually looking at Metcalf first. Second is going to be Disley, third Williams.
They go play action here on first down.
Disley, what are you doing?
Being chased out left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. You know what I like about...
Let's watch our tight end. So second play, first look at the pass play. Let's watch Disley come in. Hey, this may be a long season. Oh, my left was wide open, took off for the run. So great heads-up play for Ryan Gamer, but not a good route at all from Disley. That's a terrible route, actually. Okay. Well, great play from Ryan.
To do too much on first down. He took with the defense.
But we got DK Metcalf. We have a great receiving core.
Second and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
Oh, Walker's got that. That's a big gain.
And he'll be out
offensive line is doing a great job on the run game right now.
It's a gain of 15, first down Seahawks. Two carries for him now on the opening drive, both for good yardage.
And based on film study, they thought that there was a chance to spring him.
Should we hit Metcalf for a big touchdown? This could work. Game.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Flush to it. And he can't find anywhere to go.
It's better to take the sack. I tried to throw it away, but it was too late. Hutchinson with the great sack. Good reach.
On the previous play, they gave up a pretty good
better a sack than an interception,
right,
which is what it would have been.
Right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps back?
Look at our run offense.
They've got to figure out a big call coming up here to try and game that.
Walker starting the season, three runs, 35 yards.
Having a really nice game.
Gun dagger.
Well. Vision is excellent, but boy, look at the help he's getting. Line, I think they're pretty eager to block for him.
I'm looking at Metcalf first. Second is going to be Lockett. Check down Walker.
Out of the gun now on third down.
Metcalf.
Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was.
Pass blocking is going to be a problem this year.
Instead, it's fourth down.
Well, young offensive line. Lost a couple offensive linemen, and it showed there. It was open. It was open. Hey, first drive, you're shaking off the nerves, starting the new season. Walker played great. Ryan made some good reads, especially on that run. But we got to do more at the end of the day and score points. It's a long season, and Ryan Gamer has gotten a lot stronger in the offseason because... Hey, he got drafted in the NHL for NHL 24 and is playing for Chicago, and that series has been awesome. He's leading the league in hits in the NHL. So hopefully he can use that intensity and that strength here in football. 10-0.
Offense coming back onto the field, ready for their
defense hasn't improved. That's two drives and two scores. Come on, Jerry.
They come up first and 10.
And I know you all are wondering, Jerry's the quarterback coach as well. And Jerry's big advice for Ryan this season, don't throw it to the other team. Limit interceptions. We led the league in interceptions last year. But we also won MVP because we did a lot. I'm looking at, we got to run this. It's wide open.
They'll run with Walker to begin.
Maybe not wide open.
And he is met in his tracks behind.
Look more open than the pass, though.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Okay, let's wake up, team. Bench.
You're
running the bench.
This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of
pressure. See, this is where we used to hit fat, and we're not going to be able to do that.
Here we go on second and 12.
That calf was not open, I don't think. Got to throw it away.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
Let's see if our play still works. Different person running it. Got to find that. Where is the tight end attack? Maybe we don't have that play anymore? What happened to that play?
And that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Same playbook. I'm looking at Metcalf.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete.
So that's the big difference. It won't let me watch the replay, but if you all saw that, if you rewind it, Disley's route was really bad. It was not a sharp cut. It was a very slow route, and that would have been open. Now Metcalf across the middle. I thought he was guarded. Maybe should have hit him, but. Gotta learn the team.
Story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get on track.
We're gonna have to change our whole strategy. Moving forward. I'm not even gonna probably look for the tight end besides check down routes. It's a big change. I'm one as a quarterback, always hit the tight end. That's why in any franchise that I play, usually it's as the Kansas City Chiefs, my team. Travis Kelce breaks every record in the book every season. Hey, we stopped him. Come on. Offense, wake up. This is on you, Ryan. This is on you.
Bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
Wake up.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground.
Inside zone.
Now it'd be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team.
That was terrible lead blocking there.
They'll find some room to get this up to about
by number 57.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I'm looking at Lockett or Walker. Possibly Metcalf, actually.
Now back to throw. Yep.
He should have caught it.
Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department.
What did Jerry Rice always say? You touch it, you catch it, right?
He's missing out his first four passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ball game.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass.
Hey, Metcalf on a slant audible. I'm looking at Metcalf and Launders. Landers.
They'll set up a throw.
Nope.
Forced out to
his left. Wow, they're fast.
And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Nothing.
This first half has not gone according to plan so far offensively or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere. But it's not going to come on this
wow,
drive.
Wow, this is a different team compared to last year. Different offensive line, and you can tell, especially with the pass block. Wow, this is tough. It's going to be an adjustment, right? Last year, we started off so slow. Then we got into a rhythm and started dominating. We need to snap out of this. This is 0 for 5 for Ryan Gamer. Really no production at all. We're trying our best, though, right? So all we can do, that's 17-0.
Detroit. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
One play at a time. One play at a time. Give it to our playmaker. I'm going to run it. Give it to our playmakers, Walker and Metcalf. We got to figure out how to get Metcalf involved. Let me know. Hey, you all out there, leave a comment letting me know what plays you like for Metcalf moving forward. We need to figure out how to get Metcalf the ball about 90% of the time.
Here's Walker to start the drive. And he is going to be stopped.
That offensive line. Oh my goodness.
A loss of a full 3 yards and now wow. Second down.
That was bad. Okay, I like Metcalf on a quick slant. If depending on what the linebacker does. Nope.
They'll look to throw. Flushed yep. Up right.
What a throw though. Complete.
The defender all over him that time.
Wow.
Lead to third down.
We have to give that to Ryan because I believe that was Hutchinson coming off the corner. And it wasn't Hutchinson. But what a play across the body. Really a no-look throw. And it hit Metcalf. I guess he was a little bit behind him. But still, in that situation, that is a really good throw. We have to give that to Ryan. But at the end of the day, Metcalf did not bring the ball in. Surprisingly, when he touches it, he usually catches it. Tough catch to make, though. But hey, we will take it. That was a good play. We got to get this first down.
Now six
we have to.
Backs, six incompletions. Yeah, the defense been pretty good.
Go to Metcalf.
But he's got to start hitting some.
What are we looking at here?
He's making them better than what they actually are.
I like Metcalf on that corners route, pistol house formation.
This offense so far on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is going to be.
I don't like that play call at all. I don't like that formation.
Going to use the first.
I thought that was normal gun. That was not.
As we step aside here in this second quarter.
PA crossers. I don't like the PA. I like the inside post out gun.
An incomplete pass.
Oh, this, yep, this is
play,
it.
And that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Where is Smith? Landers has been in. Where in the world is Smith? I just noticed that he hasn't been in the game. Wide open. What a throw. What a catch.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
Linebacker on Metcalf. There's just no way. There ain't no way.
These guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked.
Finally, we made a completion.
They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Yeah, we got to put together some drives. I'm actually going to go into pass plays, shotgun, and look through the plays this way. There's our tight end attack. I don't think it's going to work this season, but I like Metcalf here if it really is single coverage over there. Oh, easy run to the left. Disley.
That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Disley. And
great route.
In the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Hey, we're getting some momentum. Legs now. A minute 55 left. Down 17-0 here in the second quarter. We're finally getting some offense going. Thank you all for the one times.
Back to throw again. Sliding out of the pocket.
Block, Walker. Block. Good block.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
Look at Ryan. That's what I'm talking about, Ryan.
That one good for 15 and a first.
That looks like the Ryan you're seeing in the NHL 24 series. Ryan getting up, about to get in a fight out there. This is not five for fighting. Ryan, you'd be thrown out. But what a run. Took a shot. Oh, my. Was that Campbell back there to hit that shot? It was Campbell. That's a shot right there. That might be the biggest shot that Ryan's taken this season. Great block by Walker, but boom. Let's see. Does it show Ryan get physical? Yes. Ryan's like, hey, I'm 1-0 in NHL 24. You want to fight, I'll fight. I'm 1-0. Ryan's got to be careful taking shots like that, because if Ryan gets out, Wilder's team's in trouble, right? We can't afford to get injured.
Much of that was planned pre-snap.
Let's run it.
It certainly opens up some avenues for their offense. And if he can stay a threat to break off those kind of runs, it'll pull defenders away from coverage and open up some choice throwing lanes for him moving forward.
Give Walker the ball. Let's get him going with the halfback zone with the lead blocker.
First points of the season
this
here.
Might not work.
First and goal. Walker.
That was just terrible blocking, but Walker makes the play.
Seahawk touchdown.
Come on.
This has not been the greatest of first halves to this point. They've been pretty well dominated.
That was shut down. What a broken tackle. Good blocking on the outside. Really good blocking on the outside.
And now on the board here on the touchdown run.
But inside, they just let him through. Walker, one person to beat, then gets outside. What a run. That's what Walker did all last season. That's a 17-7. Should be 17-7. We missed a couple extra points last season early on, if y'all remember. And we hold him. No, we get the ball back. That's right. Halftime. Well, that was huge. Get the ball back. 20-plus passing yards is the goal. Let's do it.
Down two scores here. So how do they make some changes coming out of the locker room?
Well, they've studied what they did in the first half. They've seen what the defense has thrown at them. Now they want to have a plan of attack against it. So you come out, you're not going to get all the points back.
Look at Walker go.
Get started on it. Start chopping into that lead, and maybe it'll inspire your defense to help out as well.
Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
What about a play action now?
Check until that run. That's the first time he's really gotten loose in this game.
And they have to keep that in mind.
What about a play action from the gun? We ran an inside zone out of this formation a lot. Looking at Metcalf.
Limiting him again.
Now a play fake here on first down.
I slid. They call that a flag in real life.
Move the sticks.
Ryan's getting into it with Detroit. Wow.
Really showing off some nice awareness and the ability to correctly realize when he's got a chance to tuck it and go himself.
Okay, let's do. I don't like a counter. We haven't ran too many out of that formation. Let's just slam it right up the gut.
So the ball moves into Lion territory.
I'm going to change it to the right side.
First and 10 at the 43. Straight ahead, Walker.
Beautiful.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want.
I like it.
Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Good read. It was wide open.
And some strong running there as he's down just shy of the 20 on the edge of the red zone. 80 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
EA go slot. I'm looking at Metcalf for a possible touchdown. If they are blitzing, Landers could be wide open. They're not blitzing. Here's Landers is still wide open.
Set up to throw.
Yes!
And he's got it. Caught in the end zone.
Get in there.
Touchdown.
Matt Landers, everybody.
From 21 yards away.
Come
the
on.
The Seahawks are back within a score.
First touchdown pass of the season goes to Landers. Wide open.
And he had a strong rookie year. So much more expected of him this one, as you might imagine. He threw that one with confidence and assuredness.
And I noticed that the celebration a little bit more subdued than his first touchdown pass last year as a rookie.
Yeah, he certainly is acting like he's done it before.
Oh, we've been there before, but main goal this season, limit turnovers, which we've done so far. Hopefully I didn't run it by saying that. This could be a 17-14 ball game, and it is. Defense with the stop. Come on.
And now last drive, so successful with the ground
game. Defense averaged 32 points per game last year, allowing. Until Jerry took over. As the defensive coordinator, they turned around. Let's do an 0-1 trap, single back. I'm going to say no. And I'm looking at Metcalf for a touchdown.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw.
Disley. No, I didn't see the safety.
He's going to let this go deep back over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Disley almost made that play. I didn't see the safety. So from my vision where I was at, I couldn't see the safety in between. I was looking at Disley. I'm like, oh, he's wide open. I didn't see number 24. Is that the cornerback? That is the cornerback. I did not see the cornerback. Could have been the safety. Got over there. But, wow. Almost a great catch. Really, Ryan put that ball in a great spot. Bant would have caught that. He took a shot, though, in his defense. But
just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL.
They're putting the pressure. If this is a blitz, Metcalf's wide open.
They brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that.
Good block on the edge, Metcalf. Should never have thrown that off the unbalanced foot. Bad throw. Settle down, Ryan. Settle down.
Confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown.
We need to settle down.
Completions on their first two throws has them huddling up.
No sense in doing that.
Big play here on third down to get their momentum.
That was just you should never make that throw.
Back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10.
Okay, I'm looking at Metcalf. One thing I want to look, where in the world is Smith? Smith injured? No! Smith is injured. So Smith started the game and then sprained their ACL. That stinks. Looking for Metcalf.
He'll look to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken.
That felt good.
Not before they
good read. Great throw. Got to get back to running the ball. Why did I stop? Some of you are wondering.
Route runner shows it there on third down. Very proficient.
You notice Ryan Gamer is locked in with his X Factor trait. What is our X Factor trait?
The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have.
First open target and ignores pressure. Nice.
Because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Well, they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37.
Yeah,
that's
a good run. Let's keep it up. But yeah, when you lead your team,
running the football, a big reason that they have
when you win MVP, Rookie of the Year, you get the superstar X factor. You better believe it.
I love it when a team just hops on my back and I just carry them along.
Our offensive line is playing now.
Nine before he's brought down at the 28.
I don't want.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it?
I want to throw it. Double slant.
Followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
I'm looking at Metcalf.
Second and one.
Yep. That throw. That's DK Metcalf with a huge play. Come on.
DK Metcalf, 28 yards. And the Seahawks have scored again in this third quarter.
That was behind Metcalf. What a catch. That was behind him. Makes a big play. No, never mind. That's right in the wheelhouse. A little bit behind him. It wasn't a bad throw. Wasn't perfect, but
understanding the playbook.
It was a touchdown.
Not just the plays and how to execute them, but how to do it against variety of defenses. Also understands his team better, what they can and cannot do. You can see the confidence rising in him as he plays.
Hear that? The confidence is rising, and that is so true. Slow start. This team is rolling now. Offensive line's playing better. Receivers are playing better. Getting Metcalf involved, looking at the tight end less. And I think that was the big change there. Let's keep it up, everybody. 21-17, and Detroit goes down, scores. They're a good team, really good. 24-21.
Last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score.
Wow, I love this career mode series. I really do. Love every single game.
If you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps.
That's great blocking. I wish Walker would have hit the hole there.
The onus back on your opponent, and that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
But it's outside a little bit too early, in my opinion.
It'll set up a
shock H option. This was our play last season. We used to hit Smith on this route till he was injured. I'm looking at Metcalf first and then Landers.
They'll drop the throw.
You all ever hit the button and realize it's too late, but it's too late? That's what happened there. Big mistake. I'm going
to
change Metcalf to a smart route, send him a little right at the first down line, and I'm going to probably hit him as soon as he turns in.
On third down, he'll drop
nope.
To throw.
Runs open.
Steps away to his left.
This is what Ryan does.
There he goes again.
Yes.
Out of bounds inside the 35.
Dual threat quarterback, everybody.
There on the scramble, it gets him a first down.
Wow, that's a big time play. Great blocking though. 67.
Zero fear from his side though. Never doubt for a second they pick up the first. He's ready to pull the trigger on a keeper.
I should never take that hit. Just get out of bounds, right? You all have told me that so many times in a comment. Like, you all remind me, Ryan, you can get hurt. Settle down, and you all are right. You should never take that hit as a quarterback. Just get out of bounds. Ryan likes to try the truck stick, but
so the big play
there's a place for that.
The complexion of things. Here's first and 10,
that was not
just
it.
Outside the 30.
Hey. Audible to the right.
Up the middle they run. It's Walker.
Walker with the truck stick.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
14 rushes, 114 yards.
The ball over 50 yards in two plays.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's
play
no
action.
Better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice
I
pickup.
Think play action to Metcalf, PA crossers,
he
gun flex. Could be
here.
A touchdown.
It's first and 10.
Now, I kind of like Disley here, too.
On play action, they'll throw.
Nobody's open. Cut left.
Dancing to his left.
Good read.
After tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard.
He still got it.
I do think it's fair to say that they were caught off guard a little bit. We decided not to throw it on first down. But give them credit. They recovered in time to deny him the first down yardage. But it's only second and short. So that
if we get a run with the lead blocker in there.
Set of downs.
Yeah, let's do a halfback lead dive. Get the fullback in there to block.
On second down, it's Walker.
Look at Walker fighting.
And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We are through three quarters here on NFL.
Hey, that's a good game
weekend.
So far.
We'll return with more after
really
this
good.
Break. You're watching the NFL.
We just kept fighting.
Sports.
24-21, one quarter of football left, everybody.
A hotly contested game to this point, just a
red zone up.
Separating these two teams as we get set
okay.
For the fourth quarter.
This could be a touchdown. I love that. I've never seen this play call in our playbook.
They'll look to throw here.
Yes!
And
what a route!
Seattle.
Matt Landers.
Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Seahawks answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead.
Put that on the money. No way 47 was guarding Landers on that one.
They just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here. And they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
We're rolling now. Was that three touchdown passes or two? Two or three? 28 of 24. Detroit scores. We got ourselves a ball game. 45 plus passing yards is the goal. Let's do it.
Touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth
quarter. All right, team.
And a chance to regain the lead in a tight one.
Good to see our defense. But hey, to be fair, Jerry, our defensive coordinator, lost a lot out there. Lost a lot of personnel. We don't have the defense that we had last year. We lost our Bobby Wagner. We lost a lot in the secondary. But at the end of the day, he's doing the best with what he has.
Walker now on first and 10.
What a block by 68.
He's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Let's learn our offensive line here. Let's learn who just made that block. That was number 68 with the pancake block, right? Yeah, let's learn our offensive line's names. Okay, so we have Lewis with a huge block there. We have Cross, Lewis, Rogers, Bradford, and Lucas. Okay. Yeah, I'll remember that.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys.
No
the
shot.
Ball.
We'll learn them though.
Breaks tackles and creates.
This should be
yardage,
wide open.
They almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Walker's playing amazing. He got hurt in the playoffs last year, and Wilson Jr. came in and played great. Or Wilson Jr., right? That's what I said. Was it Wilson Jr.? Jeff Wilson Jr., yeah. Came in and played well, but...
in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Just week one, but already
I love Metcalf here.
The game's going on, and this one no different as we come up on first and 10. Being chased out left.
Throw it away.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options.
Three touchdown passes for Ryan. Now, young Ryan, rookie Ryan, would have thrown a pick there, and you all know it.
Of a comeback, so that's the right call there to just throw that one away.
Second and 10.
Okay, let's get a few yards on the run here. Let Walker do his thing.
Up the middle, here's Walker.
I still like the call.
Going there is he'll only get a yard, maybe, up to the 41. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You foresee it.
They were ready for that audible.
Yeah, now maybe bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third and down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages,
okay.
Don't they?
I'm going to audible Landers to a in. Smart route it to get right at the first down line, kind of a levels concept to the right in a way. And here we go.
Back to throw here.
It's open if he makes the play. Yes.
Caught. And it's going to be another first down as he'll get him.
Ryan put that
Lions
on
35.
The money.
That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice
on
play.
The money.
What, he's been able to put the ball in some
wobbly,
tight spots all game
wobbly
long.
Pass, but it was on the different. Money.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type
what
of
a catch.
Throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
That's right. It's not that big a deal for Ryan. We're just going to keep firing. 9 minutes left
so
in the fourth. Down three.
Territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. From the gun, it's Walker shedding the tackle.
Drew Campbell right off of him with the stiff arm. Walker came to play.
Type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe
wow.
Long drive.
Tight end attack.
Kind of
this was our favorite play last
ball
year.
On the 30 now. Here's second down at 5. Flush to his right.
Wide open, Disley. Make the play.
Be caught inside the 10.
So close.
After a very nice gain. And even 30 yards on a play that began back at the 30.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved
I'm
up.
I'm going play
start.
Action shotgun.
And here's yet another big play.
EA wide receiver in.
Be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
No, that's an easy running touchdown. I mean, I want to score. This is easy for Walker.
Here's Walker.
Just walk it in, baby.
Take this one in for the Seattle touchdown.
Great audible, unselfish audible there.
Already his second
touchdown. I wanted to score with Ryan, but
and the Seahawks have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
What a comeback.
This is the time of game where offensive lines can really dictate a team's fortunes. It's been a tough battle.
Come on, defense.
They've been out there for a long time. But this was a question of who can wear down who. And that's excellent work to put a long drive together.
We are playing now, YouTube. Thank you all for all the positive, encouraging comments that you all always leave. You all are legends. Wow. Subscribe for plenty more career mode content here on the channel. Got a lot of career mode content. We have five ongoing career modes at the same time right now.
I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition.
All right. We stopped them. 35-31, 5 minutes left. Game management. Game management. Play smart. Play the game the way it's meant to be played.
They'll start this drive out on the ground.
Walker is running over everybody.
After a gain of four.
He's fired up.
This is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage.
I do like left.
Onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking
charge. Run the clock.
Sticking with Walker on
great lead block by number 80 there.
31 yard line. And even 150 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues. It carries like that. That's
let's
how
go into 2 o'clock
here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front.
Good job.
Hey guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
He'll get a nice chunk there.
Am I crazy for thinking a play action will work here?
Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running
situation. Is this crazy?
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front.
So crazy, it just might work, right?
Nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in
bounds. I don't like
it. Keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively.
This I don't like it. Here we go.
They run again with Walker.
He is dialed in. His ball carrier vision this season.
He'll get this up to about the 42. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
We're worried about the offensive line, but well.
Out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have
I was about to throw it. The announcer changed my mind. I don't know, though. We have to be a little bit of aggressive here because do you want to win or do you want to lose, you know?
Here's second and 10.
Here's the question. Is it open? No, not really. Russ Walker, though. Good run.
And he'll get about three here up to the 42.
2 minute warning. This is a huge third down.
This is a big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Dagger, gun dagger.
Third down, I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one score game. So it's
this is so nerve-wracking
as we march toward a conclusion. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead.
There it is, gun dagger. That's what I was looking for.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
I'm going to change Lockett to a more smart route to where he's going to be right at the first down line. There we go. Running back is going to stay in the block.
He'll drop to throw. Escaping the pressure right.
Throw it away. Got to be smart. Nothing's open. You don't throw a pick there. Your punter can put this down in great field position, right? Smart play. Metcalf, it was tough. It really wasn't that open. And I could have forced it, but we're a smarter player this year. We're not going to make mistakes. We're not going to give them the ball and throw the game. Get it? Our punter can pin them down into great field position for us. All right, let's change it to normal speed here. Let's see. I wish you could watch the game from here. That's one thing I wish here in NHL. I love that you can watch the game from the bench. Imagine being able to watch from the sideline. Touchback. That's not ideal. 11-yard reception. Incomplete pass. Ball on the 31. Pass knocked away.
And the Seahawks get ready to come out on the field.
Seahawks.
This game not quite in hand.
Not
yet.
Over yet. They got three timeouts. Jerry led the defense there, everybody. Come on. Wow, what a game here to start the season. It's what's so special, I think, about this career mode series. Every game is intense. It's nerve-wracking. It's fun. Love it.
Gotta have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. That's some good hard running there as he'll push his way forward for about five.
I don't like this. I know most people would say don't audible. We just have to get stopped.
He's gonna get
you can't risk throwing that. It's way too dangerous.
The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining.
Because a field goal puts them within, gives us a touchdown lead, right? So the question is, we want a field goal. Do we get aggressive and throw it? Do we run our play? Should we call timeout and think about it? I say we call timeout and think about it. I need some time. Inside zone, 4 yards. Walker can get it. If we get the first down, we win. Victory formation. Let's take a timeout.
The first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
What's the best decision here? What should we do? You all are probably talking through the whatever device you're watching on, telling me what you all think. And I like, as crazy as this might seem, I like a play action read, quick throw over the middle to Metcalf. I don't think they're going to think we're throwing this. We'll see.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw.
Open.
Rolling to his right. And that one goes incomplete on the drive.
No shot he drops that ever.
Catches fourth down.
That's right.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone,
it's right in the wheelhouse.
Along the way, he should have
kept the superstar receiver
with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds a defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it.
How does Metcalf drop that ball, YouTube? It literally was right in the hands. Right here for a superstar receiver, wide open, drops it. Look, Ryan Gamer pass dropped by DK Metcalf. You gotta trust your superstars in that position, and we did. Come on, defense. Field goal, gotta make it. There we go. 7-point game. It's 27 seconds. There's the kickoff, 24 seconds. Ball on the 25. First and 10, pass knocked away by Witherspoon. 2 seconds left, or 16 seconds left in the game. Reception to Pollard. 29-yard reception. Game over. Seahawks win.
For week one.
Get
one
in there.
Window games here in week one on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you
A
as
minus.
Well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record. But everyone's going to have to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of this season.
What a game. Are you kidding me? 38-31. Ryan Gamer leads the Seattle Seahawks to a 1-0 record to start the 2024 regular season. What a game. That's 3 touchdown passes for Ryan. No interceptions. Completion percentage a little low at 40%. Jared Goff, 234 and a touchdown. Let's take a look at all the stats here. So Jared Goff with the 79 quarterback rating, 21 for 34, a touchdown and an interception, 234 passing yards. Ryan Gamer, highest quarterback rating I think we've seen, 116, 8 for 12. No mistakes, though. A lot smarter quarterback this year for Ryan Gamer. 197 yards, 3 touchdowns, no interceptions. Got to limit the mistakes, which is what we did. Rushing, Walker. Game ball goes to Walker. 28 attempts for 171 yards and 2 touchdowns. Tony Pollard, now with Detroit, had a great game. 26-115, 2 touchdowns. So won the Super Bowl last year for the Dallas Cowboys, if y'all remember. Led Dallas Cowboys to the Super Bowl and is now on Detroit. Jared Goff had 14 rushing yards, but Ryan Gamer, 5 for 79. Still a dual threat quarterback, that one long run. What about receiving? So Metcalf, 4 for 102 and a touchdown. That one was a great play by Metcalf. Throws a little bit behind him, was still a good throw at the hands. And Metcalf did have to slow down a bit, but ended up breaking it for a touchdown. That was huge. A wide receiver core actually looked really good. Disley had a couple of good plays, couple of tough routes. Still, 2 for 64 is really good. 32 yards average. But I want to see a little bit better routes ran by Disley. We were used to those Noah Fant routes, which were amazing. We need Disley to run a little bit better routes. But overall, good throwing day. What a day for Ryan Gamer and the team. I'm going to pause the video and take a screenshot, and then we'll take a look at our next week's game. Before we do that, I had to reshow this play for y'all. This is the pass. This was that third down. The play action across the middle to Metcalf. Watch how perfect this ball is. You cannot throw it any better than the way Ryan Gamer threw this. On the run, takes a shot, wide open. Metcalf never drops that ball. I'm not convinced in real life Metcalf would ever drop that. That's a heartbreaker, but it happened. We still won the game, and that's what matters. So next week, we face off against the division rivals, the Arizona Cardinals in Arizona. So another away game to start the season. Now, last year, we had a lot of great games against the Cardinals. End up stealing the division from them by having a great end of the season and then taking them down. So we ended up winning the division. So you better believe the Cardinals are going to come out prepared for that game. That is going to be a battle. But thank you all for watching this video to the end. If you got some enjoyment, drop a like. It really helps the channel. Subscribe for more. And there is tons of Ryan Gamer career mode content you can tune into on the channel. We have 5 ongoing career modes right now. We have Madden 24, NHL 24, MLB The Show 23. We have PGA 2K23 and EA Sports PGA Tour with more coming in the future and tons more we've done in the past. You can check out the different playlists I've linked for y'all in the description for the different series. And if you want even more from me, check out my second channel, Gamer Ability 2, link in the description to that. But as always, have a fantastic day, everybody.